Hello viewers, welcome back to our YouTube channel 3D Parametric Solid Model Drawing. Today we will create an assembly file of ArborPress in Simon's NX software. In this video, you will learn the full modeling process of this model and its components. We have used 10 PAR files and one assembly to make this model. At the end of this video, we will create an animation of this assembly in motion application environment. If you want to get the file of this model, I have given the link address in the description of my video. By visiting that link, you can get it easily. Okay, alright. First of all, we will create an ArborPress frame like this. Okay, so now we will start a new inch PAR file from here. And set the location of the file like this. Save the part with the name ArborPress frame in the ArborPress assembly folder. And click OK. Alright. Now this is our design window of NX where you have to design the part. We will pick up the sketch tool from here. In the sketch selection area, we will select the XZ datum plane to start the sketching. Now activate the profile tool and start the line from the center part origin. And its length will keep 8.625 inches. Now draw another line from this endpoint. OK. Now we will draw some more lines on here like this. This line dimension will keep 1.5 inches. Okay. This dimension is 3.125 inches. Okay. Now this line dimension will keep 0.125 inches. And this dimension is 1.5 inches. Now we will create another line on the upper side and its length will keep 2.5 inches. Okay, that's it. Now we will apply another dimension 9 inches between the endpoint of the top line and baseline. Now we will draw one more line on here. and create an arc between the endpoints of these two lines for connecting the sketch. The radius of the arc is 6 inches. Draw one more line on here. And this line dimension is 1.184 inches. Okay. We will draw another arc between the endpoints of these two lines to connect the internal sketch. Now we will apply the dimension 1 inches between the center point of the two arcs. The inside arc radius is 3 inches. Okay, alright. Here my sketch is fully constrained, so we will quit the sketching mode. Now we will activate the extrude command from here. Okay. Now we will select the sketch. Okay, and fix the extrude distance value 3.5 inches. Click OK. Hide the visibility of the sketch. See, my first extrude feature has been created on here. Now we will increase the model edge in the following way by using the visualization command so that our part looks better than before. Okay, alright, now see the result. See, now my model is looking perfect. Now we will start a new sketch on the top face of the frame. Draw an arc between these two side edges. Okay, and apply the tangent constraint between the arc and side edge of the frame. Draw a horizontal line over the side edge of the frame like this. And draw a slanted line here. Okay. We will take the project of this edge and convert it to reference geometry. Okay, alright. Fix the angular dimension 15 degrees between the slanted line and side edge. Draw a horizontal line over the center of the face for mirroring the sketch. This line dimension is 4.313 inches. create another arc over the end of the line to close the sketch. The arc radius is 1.25 inches. Now this arc radius is 1.312 inches. Okay, that's it. Now we will create a mirror of the sketch like this. Draw one more line to complete the sketch. So now we will quit the sketching mode. Now we will activate the extrude command. And select this sketch profile. Selecting this sketch here, we will mold it in our frame according to this sketch shape so that our frame looks like this with the help of intersect option by this tool. Click OK to finish the command. Now you can see my shape is created as I want. Wow, it looks great. Save the PAR file. Okay, that's it. Let's start a sketch on the front face. Take the project of entire body. And convert the entire sketches into reference geometry. Draw a vertical line from here. This line dimension is 2.365 inches. Draw a horizontal line on the lower area. Draw another vertical line from here. Fix the offset distance value 0.375 inches between this line and the side edge. Okay, alright. And draw an arc between the end points of these two lines to connect it. The arc radius is 3.375 inches. Fix the tangent constraint on this arc and this line. Fix the collinear constraint between the line and the slot edge. Give another dimension of 2.434 inches between these two lines. Now create an arc on the end points of the lines to connect it. Okay, that's it. Finish the sketch. Now we will cut this sketch profile 1.469 inches by using extrude command. Now see the result. My slot is cut over the frame. We will start the new sketch over this slot face, okay? Now take the project of this slot face, okay? Convert the projected curve into reference geometry. Now we will take the offset of the outer projected sketches like this. The offset distance is 0.375 inches. Now we will trim this arc on here. And convert these geometries into normal lines. Okay, now my sketch is complete. So we will activate the extrude command and cut this profile 0.125 inches. Let's start the sketch over this face. Now we will create a circle on here and its diameter will be 1.75 inches. Here now we will apply the vertical and horizontal constraint between the circle and model edges. Okay, create some more lines like this over the projected lines. Create an arc from the end of the referenced curve. Draw a vertical line and snap it by applying the coincident constraint. Fix the dimension 0.375 inches between this line and y-axis. We will extend this arc on this line, okay. And erase the extra lines here, okay. Draw one more line. And trim this line and circle like this. Set the dimension 0.35 inches. Okay, fix the equal radius constraint between these two arcs. Okay, finish the sketch. Now we will cut this profile 0.875 inches by using extrude command. Create a new datum plane by selecting the two side faces of the frame. Okay. See, my plane has been created here over the mid of the frame. And create a mirror by selecting these two extrude cut features on the basis of the center plane like this. Okay, alright. Create a new sketch over this face. Create a rectangle on here. Fix the collinear constraint between these two lines. Now we will create a dimension on here, it will keep 0.375 inches. Apply another dimension 1.75 inches between these two lines. Okay, so we will finish the sketch. Activate the extrude command and select this. Choose the reverse side option and now choose until next option and click OK. See the result, my slot is cut over the frame. Now rotate the model in opposite direction. And we will create one more extrude cut feature over this face of the model in the following way. Okay, alright. Open the visibility of the mid plane and start the new sketch on this plane. Take the project of the entire body like this. Now we will activate the Edit Section View command by selecting the mid plane. Create a rectangle on here. And give the dimension 0.5 inches between these two lines. Its height will keep 1.184 inches. Draw an arc over this rectangle. And the radius is 0.75 inches. Fix the tangent constraint between the line and this arc. Okay, and finish the sketch. Now deactivate the section view. Activate the extrude command. Okay. And cut the sketch region 1 by 2 inches on the both sides from the mid plane by using the symmetric value option. Okay, that's it. Now see my slot is cut on here. Save the PAR file. Now we will create hole on this face in the following way. The hole diameter is 1.172 inches. and its depth is 1.5 inches. Now we will start the sketch on the inner slot face. And take the project of this sketch. Draw a circle and its dia is 0.751 inches. Exit the sketch and cut this circle through all the body. Okay, now see. Create a new sketch on this face. And take it project. Convert the projected lines into construction geometry. Okay. Now create an arc on here. This dimension is 1.25 inches. Fix the tangent constraint over the both endpoints of the arc and line. Now we will draw the two lines on the arc like this. Okay. Now we will create a slot by selecting this sketch profile. The depth of the slot is 0.594 inches. Now see. And mirror this over the opposite side. Activate the edge blend tool and fix the blend radius value 0.625 inches. Now we will give the fillet on the edges of the frame like this. Okay, that's it. Now we will create a new sketch on the inner face of the frame. Draw a horizontal line over the center of the part. Okay, draw a rectangle on here and fix the vertical constraint on the mid of the rectangle line and center line. Now create an arc on here. And its radius is 0.532 inches. Apply the dimension 0.75 inches between center point of the arc and the side edge. Fix the tangent constraint over the arc and line. Finish the sketch. Activate the extrude command to make one more slot through all over the body by selecting this sketch. Now see my slot is cut over the frame part. Now we will create a custom fillet over this face. And mirror it to the opposite side. Create a new sketch over the bottom face of the frame. And take the project of this face by using the project curve command. take an offset inside of this outer projected sketch. The offset distance is 0.312 inches. Okay, that's it. Finish the sketch. Now activate the extrude command and cut the sketch profile 1.1875 inches. Click OK. Now see the result. Start the sketch over the front face. And draw a rectangle on here. Fix the dimension 3 inches between the side edge and rectangle line. Width and height of the rectangle will keep 2.562 and 0.125 inches. Now activate the extrude command, choose through all option. And click OK. Create another new sketch on the bottom face. Now draw a rectangle on here. Fix the width of the rectangle 3 inches. Take the project of these curves. Fix the dimension 1.999 inches between this line and the center point of the arc. Okay, finish the sketch. And extrude the rectangle 0.5 inches. Now see, my feature is looking perfect. Let's start the sketch over midplane. Now we will take the project of the entire body. Convert the entire sketches into reference geometry. And draw an aligned line like this. Set the angular dimension 30 degrees between these two lines. Now draw two more lines on the projected edge. Okay, finish the sketch. Now activate the extrude command and select the sketch. Select the subtract option. Now we will select the until extended option under the start area. And select this inside slot face of the frame. Okay. Then next, select the until extended option under the end area here also. And select the opposite side slot face of the frame. Alright. And click OK. Now see here, my taper face has been made. Hide the visibility of the sketch and midplane. Activate the Edge Blend tool. Rotate the model over the rear side. Now we will select these four bottom edge. The fillet radius is 0.125 inches. And click OK. Now see, it looks great. Now rotate the frame in this position and pick up the whole tool. Here we will select the threaded hole option. Now choose 1x4-20 size under the thread dimension area. The thread depth is 0.5 inches. Okay. The hole depth is 0.752 inches. Here we will disable the start and end chamfer. Thread standard is inch UNC. Now we will set the location of the hole where I want to create it. Okay, now select this face. First, second, third and fourth. Now we will fix the vertical constraint between these two points. Select this one and this one, then fix it. Now we will fix the horizontal constraint between these two points. Okay, that's it. Fix the dimension 1.25 inches between these two points. Now apply another dimension 0.25 inches between the top edge and this point. Okay, alright, quit the sketch. Click OK to finish the hole command. Now see here, my four holes are successfully created on the frame. It looks great. Now we will create the sketch on this face and take the project of the whole edge. Draw a circle from the whole center point. Its diameter is 1.374 inches. Okay, finish the sketch. Select the sketch region. Okay, we will activate the extrude command. Fix the distance value 0.375 inches and click OK. Now create the sketch over the top face. Draw a circle of 0.125 inch diameter on here. And apply the vertical constraint between the sketch origin and center point of the circle. Give the dimension 0.188 inches between this edge and the center point of the circle. Okay, finish the sketch. Create a hole over this circular face by using extrude command. Now we will start the sketch on this face. On here our CSYS of the sketch is not showing properly because it tilted here. So we will correct it by using the specify CSYS command in the following way. Open its detailed dialog box from here. First we will select this face. Okay, and then next. Select the x-axis for the specify vector. Okay, at last we will select the endpoint of this vertical edge and click OK to finish the command. See, my CSYS of the sketch is showing properly here. So now we will take the project of these faces of the frame. And draw a circle on here and its diameter will keep 0.406 inches. Apply another dimension 5.625 inches between these two center points. This dimension will keep 0.75 inches. Okay, alright, finish the sketch. Now we will create a hole over this face by selecting this circle. And mirror the hole on the opposite side. Now we will create another small hole over the front side of the frame like this. Let's start the sketch on the front face. Create a rectangle over here. Fix the constraints on this rectangle to fix it. Its width will be 0.749 inches. Now we will create a slot by selecting this circle by using the extrude command. The slot depth value will be 0.752 inches. Now we will create a mirror of this slot over the bottom side of the frame like this. Rotate the model over the back side. Okay, and start the sketch on this face. Draw a rectangle on here. Exit the sketch. Okay, activate the extrude command, select the sketch and choose the unite option. Set the distance value 0.67 inches and click OK. Now see, my face is plain on here. In the same manner, we will fill this oval surface in the following way. Okay, that's it. Now activate the edge blend command and give the fillets on the side edge of the frame like this. Fillet radius is 0.125 inches. Okay, alright. Now we will create one small hole over the top face of the model in the following way. Now we will apply the remaining fillets over the frame like this. Okay, that's it. Now my frame is looking perfect. Finally, my arbor frame has been completed here. I hope you may like this model. Now we will create a second PAR file, name it as faceplate. Now we will close the arbor frame part on here. Now we will create another new inch PAR file from here. Save the part, name it as faceplate in the Arbor Press assembly folder. And click OK. Now let's start the new sketch on XZ datum plane. And draw a center point rectangle from the center part origin. The height of the rectangle is 2.5 inches. And the width is 1.75 inches. Okay, quit the sketch. Okay, activate the extrude command and extrude this sketch 0.5 inches from this plane. Now pick up the whole tool. Here we will select the general hole option. The diameter of the hole is 0.25 inches. And its depth is through all over the body. Okay, that's it. Here we will set the location of the hole where I want to create it. Okay, so now select this face. First, second, third, and fourth. Now we will fix the horizontal constraint between these two points. Select this one, and fix the vertical constraint between them. Okay, alright. Now we will fix the dimension 0.25 inches between the top edge and this point. In the same manner, we will fix the same dimension between the lower point and the bottom edge. Fix the dimension on the side edge and this point. It will also keep 0.25 inches. Now we will apply the dimension over the remaining points in the following way. So now my points are fully constrained here. Quit the sketch. And click OK to finish the whole command. Okay, that's it. My holes are created on this faceplate. Now, activate the edge blend tool from here and give the fillets on the four corner edge of the faceplate like this. The fillet radius is 0.25 inches. Okay, alright, now we will activate the True Shading button. so that my part can be visible much better. It's looking very nice. Let's install the new sketch on the front face. Now create a rectangle here. Its width is 0.875 inches. And the height is 1.5 inches. Fix the vertical constraint between the midpoint of the rectangle and top edge. And now we will fix the horizontal constraint between the midpoint of the rectangle and the side edge. Okay, finish the sketch. Now we will create a slot by using the extrude command. Okay, slot depth is 0.125 inches. Now we will activate the hole tool from here and select the thread hole option. The thread standard is inch UNF. Okay, alright. Now choose #10-32 size under the thread dimension area. The thread depth is 0.75 inches. The hole depth limit is through all over the body. Here we will disable the start and end chamfer of the hole. Now we will set the location of the hole. We have selected this face. Place the two center points on here and fix the constraints on these two points to fix it. Now we will apply the vertical dimension 0.5 inches between these two points. Okay, finish the sketch. Now see here, my two threaded holes are created over the slot face. Now we will create another big hole on the top surface of the faceplate in the following way. Okay, all right, the hole is created here. Now we will apply the fillets on these internal edges of the slot. Okay, now my internal edges are looking perfect. My arbor frame faceplate has been completed here. So now we will create a third part, name it as pinion shaft. Okay, all right. Now we'll start the new sketch over the exit plane. First of all, we will create the sketch of one tooth of my pinion shaft, then extrude it, and afterwards we will create a circular pattern of this tooth 12 times. Okay, alright. So now we will create a horizontal line from the part origin. And convert this line into reference geometry. Now draw a slanted line from the center part origin. And its aligned dimension is 0.586 inches. Okay, alright. Place the angular dimension 7.5 degrees between the slanted line and center construction line. Now draw another slanted line on the opposite side like this. And its aligned dimension is 0.404 inches. Its angular dimension has also been the same. Create an arc from the end of the slanted line. Here we will draw two lines in the following way that will join both the end points of the arc with its center point. Okay, alright, now we will set the arc angle on here. The arc angle is 3.86 degrees. The arc radius is 0.404 inches. Now draw another arc on here. In the same manner, we will give the dimension of this arc that we had done earlier. The arc angle is 86.695 degrees. And fix the tangent constraint between these two arcs. Drag the sketch from this endpoint of the line like this. Okay. And the arc radius is 0.02 inches. Alright. Create a horizontal line from the arc endpoint and its length is 0.047 inches. Fix the tangent constraint between this line and arc. Draw another arc on here like this. The arc angle is 16.396 degrees. Okay, that's it. Convert these two slanted lines into a reference geometry. And the arc radius is 0.109 inches. Next, we will create an arc from the end of the previous arc. And its angle is 21.636 degrees. Drag the arc end point here. And fix the coincident constraint between these two arcs. Drag the arc like this. And fix the radius 0.268 inches. Now we will give the dimension 0.58 inches between the end point of the arc and center part origin. Okay, my sketch is almost finished here. So now we will create a mirror of these arcs and lines. Convert this line into reference geometry. And activate the mirror curve command from here. Select the entire sketches here. Choose the center line. Now choose the center line on here and click OK. Now draw an arc between these endpoints of the arc for connecting the sketch. And the arc radius is 0.586 inches. So now my tooth sketch is fully constrained here. We will exit the sketch. Activate the extrude command. Select the tooth sketch. OK. Now choose the reverse direction button. Fix the extrude distance value 1 inch. And click OK. Now see here, my tooth is looking perfect. Let's pick up the pattern feature command from here. Select this extrude feature. Now here choose the circular option under the layout section. In the rotation axis area, we will select the horizontal edge of the tooth. Okay. In the angular direction area, we will choose the count and span option. The pattern count value is 12 and the span angle is 360 degrees. And click OK. OK, alright, now see here, my circular pattern is created and pinion shaft is looking very fine. In the type selection filter section, we will select the solid body option. Hover the mouse pointer on this part, you can see that each circular pattern features is shown here separately because multiple solid bodies are generated in this part. So now we will convert the entire solid body into a single solid body by using the unite command. Okay, alright, activate the unite command. First select the extrude feature and then next select the pattern feature. And click OK. See, all the feature edges are hidden by using this command. Now my pinion shaft is looking perfect. Let's install the new sketch over the rear side of the model. And draw a circle from the center point. Its diameter will keep 1.172 inches. Now activate the extrude command, OK, and extrude the circle 2.813 inches from this face. OK, that's it. Now we will create a new sketch over the front face. Draw a circle from the center point. Its diameter will keep 0.748 inches. Quit the sketch. Now we will extrude this circle 1.187 inches from the front face. Activate the chamfer tool from here. Fix the chamfer distance value 0.0625 inches, okay, and apply the chamfer over the front and rear edge of the model. Now we will start the new sketch over the XY datum plane. Draw a circle on here and its diameter will keep 0.515 inches. Fix the point on curve constraint between the circle and Y axis. And fix the dimension 0.5 inches between the outer edge and center point of the circle. Finish the sketch. Make a hole by selecting this circle using the extrude command. Now we will create a new sketch on this face. Activate the project curve command. And take the project of the outer boundary of the tooth sketch. Create a center point arc on the outside of the pinion. Now we will extend the curve by adding the two arcs here. Okay, and snapped the endpoint of the arc by using the coincident constraint like this. Here we will erase extra curves by using the quick trim command like this. Now my sketch profile is closed on here. Now we will draw a slanted line between the endpoints of the arc. In the same manner, we will create another line outside of the part and fix the parallel constraint between these two slanted lines. Now apply the dimension over this arc. Create a slanted line from the part origin and fix the coincident constraint between the line and midpoint of this arc. Now this dimension is 1.575 inches. And snap this endpoint of the line on the end of this line. Okay, finish the sketch. Now rotate the model in this position. Now create a datum axis of this line. Edit the sketch and convert this line into a reference geometry. Now we will activate the revolve command from here. And select this sketch. Choose specify vector option and select this axis. Now you can see the revolve feature preview is visible in the design window. Choose the subtract option and click OK to finish the command. Now see here my slot is cut over the cylindrical surface of the pinion by using this tool. Okay, it is looking very fine. Now we will activate the pattern tool from here. Okay, and select the revolve one feature from here. Now select the specify vector option to specify the rotation axis. And then next we will select the y axis of the pinion. The occurrence count value is 12. Okay. Okay, in the orientation area, we will choose follow face option. Now we will select the cylindrical surface of the pinion shaft and click OK to finish the command. Now my model is looking perfect. Save the part file. Rotate the model on the rear side. Okay, now we will activate the whole command. Here, select the inch UNC thread standard. Okay, the thread size is 1x4-20. The thread depth is 8 mm. Now we will select this face. And then next we will fix this whole center point into the center part origin. Okay. Now we will fix the direction of the hole by using specify vector option. And click OK to finish the command. It is looking very nice. Okay, now see my part is complete on here, so we will close the file. Next, we will create a RAM model. Okay, alright. So, we will create another new PAR file from here. And start the sketching over the XZ datum plane. Now draw a center point rectangle from here. Apply the equal constraint between two sides of the rectangle like this. And fix the height of the rectangle 0.75 inches. Okay, finish the sketch. Now we will extrude the sketch 7.75 inches. And click OK. Now see. My plate of the RAM model is created here. Next, we will cut a tooth on this plate. So now we will create a tooth sketch on the front face of the plate. Now take the project of the face and convert the entire sketches into reference geometry. Draw three lines on here, something like an Acme thread sketch profile. It is called Acme thread sketch profile, but its angle value is 29 degrees. In my case, we will set the angle value 40 degrees on here. Okay, that's it. Now we will activate the rapid dimension tool and fix the dimension of this line. It will keep 0.061 inches. And now select these two ends of the lines, then fix the dimension 0.192 inches. Okay, now we will fix the angular dimension 40 degrees between these two slanted lines. Draw a vertical line over the mid of the lower line. And we will apply the symmetric constraint over the both sidelines by selecting this referenced line. Create another horizontal line on here to close the sketch profile. Now select this point, okay, and apply the dimension 0.937 inches. So now my sketch is complete. Quit the sketch. Now we will create a slot by selecting this sketch by using the extrude command like this. See, my tooth is created over this plate. Now we will make a linear pattern of this cut extrude feature. Let's install the pattern feature command and select the extrude feature. Now choose the specify vector button and we will select the horizontal edge of the plate. Okay. Now choose the reverse direction button. The spacing will keep count and pitch. The pattern count value is 23 and the pitch distance is 0.262 inches. And click OK to create a pattern feature. See, the entire teeth are successfully created on this plate by using this tool. It is looking very nice. Okay, now my RAM model is completed on here. So we will close the file and create another new inch part file from here. Its name is lever arm. And start the sketching. Now draw a circle of diameter 0.5 inches. Extrude this circle 10 by 2 inches from the center plane. The actual length of this lever arm is 5 inches. Okay, alright. My lever arm model has been completed, so close the part. Now we will create a new part file from here, okay. Choose XZ plane to start the sketch. Now we will create two circles from the center part origin, and outer circle diameter will keep 0.75 inches and the inner circle diameter is 0.5 inches. Okay, finish the sketch. Extrude this sketch region 0.625 inches in this direction. Okay, alright. Now we will apply the chamfer on the front edge. The chamfer distance value is 0.031 inches. Click OK. Now we will apply the fillet on the back edge. Okay. Change the color of the model as iron gray. Okay, alright, now my handle cap part has been completed here, so close the part. And start the new inch part file from here. Its name is collar. Okay, alright. Now we will start the sketch on this plane. And we will create two circles from the part origin. An outer circle diameter is 1.125 inches. The inner circle diameter is 0.75 inches. Okay, finish the sketch. Extrude the sketch 0.375 inches on here. Save the part file. Now we'll apply the chamfer on the front circular edge. Okay. Now we will create a threaded hole over the mid plane of the model. Please follow these steps. Okay, all right. Now my hole is created and close the file. Now we'll create another part, name it as table plate. Let's start the sketch on the XZ datum plane. Now I will draw a circle on here and its diameter is 3.5 inches. And extrude it 2.5 inches. Okay. Now draw one more sketch on this face. Create a circle on here, its diameter will keep 2.25 inches. Now draw the small circle over the intersection of the previous circle and its diameter is 0.56 inches. Fix the point on curve constraint between the center point of the circle and the y-axis. Okay, and convert the circle into reference geometry. Now we will take the project of the outer boundary of the feature. It will also keep as reference geometry. Now draw the two vertical lines on both sides of the circle like this. And apply the tangent constraint between the line and circle. Now we will erase the extended lines and arcs by using the quick shrink command. Now we will extend this sketch region in the following way so that when we create the slot by selecting this sketch, then no part of it is left outside. Okay, now see here, my slot is successfully created on here. Now we will pattern this extrude cut feature 4 times by using the circular pattern tool. Now we will change the part color from here. Okay, it is looking perfect. And we will apply the fillets on these four slot edges of the part like this. It is looking very nice. Here we will create a small hole over the center of the plate. My part is completed here, so we will close the part file. Now we will create two miscellaneous part files, which name is GIB plate and groove pin in the following way. Okay, close the part file. Okay, that's it. Finally, all the components of the Arbor Press model are finished here. So now we will create a new inch assembly file in Siemens NX. and set the name of this assembly Arbor Press Assembly and click OK. See here, the add component command has already been activated in the assembly design window. At first, we will place the Arbor Press frame in this assembly. OK, now we will select the file from the parts folder. And click OK to place the part. See on this dialog box, it will ask you that it is the first part that you placed in this assembly. Do you want to fix it? Click Yes button. OK, that's it. Now we will hide the visibility of the entire visible work planes and sketches of the part by using the Show and Hide button. Now my part is looking perfect in this assembly. Here we will check the degree of freedom of this part. See here. See, there is no degree of freedom on this part because the fixed constraint has already been applied. So now we will place the faceplate by using the add component command. Now rotate the assembly in this position, OK. Hide the sketch visibility here. Now we will activate the move component command and rotate the faceplate in this position. And drag it in an upward direction. Okay. Now activate the assembly constraints command. Now we will choose the infer central axis option from here and then next we will select the whole axis of the faceplate and the whole of the frame. Okay. And apply the axis mate between them. Now drag the faceplate by dragging the rotation node. Okay, then apply another infer center axis constraint between these two whole axes. Now we will select the touch constraint here and apply this constraint between the front face of the frame and back face of the faceplate part. Okay, alright, now see here my faceplate is fully fixed over the Arbor Press frame. Now we will check the degree of freedom of this part. Okay, now see the result. hide the visibility of the assembly constraints. So now we will insert the next part. Here we will insert the pinion shaft in this assembly. Rotate and drag the model in this position by selecting the Move Component command. And fix the pinion shaft over the large hole of the arbor frame by applying the invert center axis constraint. Now drag the pinion shaft in an outward direction. Okay, all right. Now we will fix the touch constraint between the back teeth face of the pinion shaft. And the inside slot face of the frame. Okay, now see the result. My pinion is rotating on the whole axis of the frame. Okay, it looks great. Now we will insert the lever arm part on here. And fix the invert center axis constraint between the lever arm and the hole of the pinion shaft. Now we will select the lever arm and pinion shaft, right click and choose the isolate in new window option. You can see only two parts are visible here by using this option. And open the visibility of the coordinate system of these two components. Okay, that's it. Now we will fix the touch constraint between the XY datum plane of pinion shaft and XZ datum plane of the lever arm. Now we'll close the isolate window and activate the move component command. Select the lever arm, okay, then next Click this point to rotate the part like this. See here, the lever arm is rotating with my pinion shaft. Okay, that's it. The constraints are properly working on here. Next, we will place the handle cap in this assembly. Now we will place the two copies of this part. In the count section, set the number of instances value to and place the part. See, the two parts are placed here. Okay, so now we will adjust the part like this. Fix these caps over the lower arm in the following way. So now my caps are properly fixed over the handle. It is looking very nice. Now we will insert the table plate on here. And fix the infra center axis constraint between the small hole of the frame and table plate. Okay, alright, now we will fix the touch constraint between the rear face of the table plate. this face of the frame. Now rotate the plate in this position. And apply the angle constraint between the XY datum plane of the table plate and the internal face of the frame. Fix the angle 180 degrees on here and click OK. Now save the assembly. Now place the collar part on here and rotate the part something like this. And apply the inverse center axis constraint between the hole of the collar and the outer circular face of the frame. Now we will fix the touch constraint between this face and back face of the collar part. Okay, alright. Now place the GIB plate in this assembly. And fix the touch constraint between the front face of the GIB plate and the inside slot face of the face plate. Now we will fix the distance constraint between the top faces of the GIB plate and face plate. Okay, set the offset distance value 0.605 inches. Click apply button. Okay, now rotate the assembly and fix another distance constraint between the side face of the GIB plate and frame. Now we will fix the offset distance value 0.559 inches, okay. hide the visibility of the faceplate like this. Okay, now see my plate is fixed over this assembly. Now we will insert the next part, groove pin. And fix the pin over the small hole of the table plate in the following way. Now we will insert the RAM model in this assembly. Okay, activate the move component command and rotate the RAM in a vertical position by selecting its rotational node from here. The teeth of the part will keep inside of the frame. Okay, alright, activate the assembly constraints command. And now we will fix the touch constraint between the front face of the RAM part and the inner face of the faceplate like this. Okay, that's it. Now we will fix another touch constraint between the inside face of the frame and the side face of the RAM. Drag the part in an upward action. Okay. Now we will insert the thumb screw in this assembly. And fix the screw over the front hole of the pinion by using the infer center axis constraint and touch constraint. Okay, that's it. Now open the visibility of the coordinate system and datum planes of the entire assembly. And apply the angle constraint between the plane of this screw and XY plane of the lever arm so that screw will also be moved with the handle. Okay, alright, now we will close the visibility of the entire planes. Now we will drag the lever arm on here to check the result. Place the two copies of M5 into 16 bolts in this assembly. And fix the bolts on the hole of the faceplate like this. Okay, that's it. So now my bolts are placed over the faceplate. Okay, that's it. So now my bolts are placed over the faceplate. Next, we will insert the 1x4-20 bolt in this assembly. It's four copies placed here. Adjust the bolts in this position. And fix the infracenter axis constraint between the bolt and the hole of the faceplate. In the same manner, we will fix the axis constraint on the remaining bolts. Okay, now we will select these bolts. And faceplate. Right click and choose the isolate in a new window option. Okay, now activate the assembly constraints command. And fix the touch constraint between the back head face of the bolt and front face of the faceplate. In the same manner, we will fix the remaining bolts on the faceplate. See, my four bolts are properly placed here. Okay, all right. We will rotate lever arm on here. See, my collar part is moving. Now we will fix this part by using the angle constraint. Because we don't want the collar to rotate when the lever arm is turned. Okay, now activate the assembly constraints command. And fix the constraint between the YZ datum plane of the collar. And this face of the frame. Okay, now see the result. My collar is fixed here. Okay, now my assembly has been almost completed here. In the next section of this video, we will create an animation of this assembly. We will fix the align constraint between these two faces of the part. And apply the angle constraint between XZ plane of lever arm and the top face of the frame. Set the angle value 90 degrees. Okay. See here, no degree of freedom are in these two components. Before we go into the animation here, we will suppress these two mates. Now we will check the degree of freedom in these two components. Okay, now see the result. Both will go to their respective places. So now we will pick up the motion command. So now we will pick up the motion command from here. Okay. Activate the new simulation tool. And save the animation assembly by its default location. In the Environment dialog box, the Dynamic option is selected by default. In the Joint Wizard area, we will disable the Start Joint Wizard upon New Simulation option here, because we will create the joints manually in this assembly. Okay, we will uncheck this option here and click OK to close the dialog box. Now we will create a relationship between the ram and pinion shaft by using the two joints. One is the sliding joint and the second is the rolling joint. And afterwards, we will fix the rack and pinion joint between the ram and pinion shaft. Okay, that's it. Now we will activate the motion body tool. It will ask you that which you want to move components. Okay, at first we will enable the fix the motion body without joint option. It means that first of all we will fix the part which is not to rotate with the help of this option. Now choose this option and select the components like arbor frame, face plate, pin and bolts, etc., etc., from the design window. Okay, see here 13 objects are selected and click OK to execute the command. Go on the motion bodies here. Now see one fixed group is created, name it as B001. Okay, alright. Reactivate the motion body command once again. But this time we will disable the fixed motion body option. Okay, now we will make two groups of motion bodies here. First group will be lever arm, pinion shaft and thumb screw. Okay, now select these components like this. Okay. See, my first motion group is created in the motion bodies browser bar. And the second group will be RAM. Okay, now select the RAM model. See, the second motion group is created in the motion navigator bar. In this way, you can see that the three groups have been formed. Here, the first one is fixed. And the other two are moving bodies. Okay, that's it. Rotate the assembly in this position and activate the joint tool. In the joint dialog box, now see many joints are listed here like revolute, slider, screw, universal, etc., etc. Okay, so now we will select the slider joint here. In the action section, first of all, select the motion body which you want to slide it. Okay, now select the front face of the RAM model. It is asking that to specify the vector here, we will select the Z-axis. Now see here on this orange arrow, it denotes that my RAM model is moving in an upward direction. If you want to change the direction of this part, you can change it here. In the base section, it is asking on whose basis do you want to play this part. Here we will select the top face of the frame and click OK to finish the command. Okay, now see my slider joint is attached under the joints folder in the motion navigator bar. If do you want to any changes of this joint, you can edit it from here. Okay, alright. Next, we will attach the revolute joint to the pinion shaft. Okay, so now we will select the revolute joint here. The action body here will be second group that I made earlier of the lever arm and pinion shaft. Now select this group. Okay, now we will fix the origin here. Open the point dialog box. And fill X, Y, and Z coordinates value here like this. And click OK. Select the y-axis from the design window to specify the vector. Now see here on this orange arrow, it shows the position of my pinion shaft. Okay, in the base section, we will select the cylindrical surface of the frame. Because it will be rotated on the base of this frame. And click OK to finish the command. Now we will edit the revolute joint. Go on the driver tab and select the polynomial option under the rotation area. Set the value 57.5 degrees per second in the velocity input box. If you want to change the unit of the time, here three more options are available. And click OK to close the dialog box. Save the motion assembly. Okay, alright. Next, we will link the slider and revolute joint to each other by using the rack and pinion command. Okay, that's it. So now go on the coupler panel and pick up this tool. In the rack and pinion dialog box, first of all, we will select the slider joint. Okay, now we will select the slider joint from the motion navigator bar. Now see my slider joint is selected. In the second joint section, we will select the revolute joint from the motion navigator bar. Okay. Now we will set the contact point on here and open its detailed dialog box. Fill the X, Y, and Z coordinates value here like this. And click OK. Set the value 0.47 inches in the ratio input box. And click OK to finish the command. Now you can see here my rack and pinion has been successfully established between the slider and revolute joints. Now we will activate the solution button. Watch the tooltip of this tool that how it works. In this dialog box, we will fix the time value 9.54 seconds. This is the total time of the animation assembly. Okay, alright, the number of steps is 191. Okay. And enable the solve with OK option. Click OK to close the dialog box. Now this is the information window at your own screen. Go on the analysis tab and activate the animation button. Now see the total time of animation is visible in the animation dialog box. The animation delay is 25. The animation play will keep retrace. This means that this assembly will be closed and reopened. So now my assembly is ready for animation. We will activate the full screen button to view the full assembly. And rotate the assembly in this position. Click the play button to start the animation. Okay, that's it. Now see our rack, pinion shaft and lever arm components are animating perfectly here. It is looking very nice. Okay, now my animation is completed here. We will click the stop button and close the dialog box. And exit from the clean screen. Okay, alright. Finally, my Arbor Press assembly has been completed here in Simons NX. I hope you will enjoy this video. If you may like this video, please like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Please share this video with your friends and colleagues. So now I will meet you in our next video. Okay friends, bye bye and have a nice day.